Welcome to New Horizon Vineyard's Good Friday worship experience. Station 2, His Cross. I will be reading from John 19, 16 through 18, John 10, 11 and 18, and Hebrews 12, 2 through 3. This is a guided experience between you and God. As you listen, pay attention to what stands out to you and touches your heart. Use the silence to hold that thought in your mind and ponder it. Ask what God is showing you or saying to you. Consider what response God is inviting in you. Finally, Pilate handed him over to them to be crucified. So the soldiers took charge of Jesus. Carrying his own cross, he went out to the place of the skull, which in Aramaic is called Golgotha. Here they crucified him. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross. Consider him who endured so much opposition from sinful men, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. The wood of the cross is not just the place Jesus was crucified. It is an altar. Altars are where sacrifices are offered, where an ugly death makes ugly sin gruesomely apparent. Think of Jesus' mangled body hanging there. That's how awful sin is. We do well to remember that when we're tempted to think sin is fun or no big deal. The wood of this cross is also a wall. In the Old Testament, at the time of the Exodus, the children of Israel put blood on the doorpost of their homes so the angel of death would pass over them, thus Passover. That blood-soaked wood protected them from righteous judgment. This blood-soaked wood protects you. And the wood of this cross is a doorframe. It opens eternity to you. The forgiveness it provides brings you to heaven, and heaven to you here on earth. Jesus loved you enough to go there for you. What more can he do to convince you of his love? Jesus, I am so grieved by my sin. I get careless about it sometimes in my life. But when I look at this cross, I get a glimpse again of how costly it is. Thank you for loving me enough to show me without shaming me. Your love is so amazing. I have no other hope than what you did for me. I can't heal myself, but you can. You did, and you are worthy to receive all my praise. Amen.